According to new research, a unique form of light made using an ancient Namibian gemstone could be the key to new light-based quantum computers, which could solve long-held scientific mysteries. The research was published in Nature Materials today. The study used a naturally mined cuprous oxide gemstone from Namibia to produce Rydberg polaritons, the largest hybrid particles of light and matter ever created. Rydberg polaritons switch continually from light to matter and back again. In Rydberg polaritons, light and matter are like two sides of a coin, and the matter side is what makes polaritons interact with each other. This interaction is crucial because this allows the creation of quantum simulators, a particular type of quantum computer, where information is stored in quantum bits. Unlike the binary bits in classical computers that can only be 0 or 1, these quantum bits can take any value between 0 and 1. They can therefore store much more information and perform several processes simultaneously. This capability could allow quantum simulators to solve essential mysteries of physics, chemistry, and biology. For example, how to make high-temperature superconductors for high-speed trains, how cheaper fertilizers could be made, potentially solving global hunger, or how proteins fold, making it easier to produce more effective drugs. The researcher said, "Making a quantum simulator with light is the holy grail of science. We have taken a huge leap towards this by creating Rydberg polaritons, the key ingredient." To create Rydberg polaritons, the researchers trapped light between two highly reflective mirrors. A cuprous oxide crystal from a stone mined in Namibia was then thinned and polished to a 30 micrometer thick slab thinner than a strand of human hair and sandwiched between the two mirrors to make Rydberg polaritons 100 times larger than ever demonstrated before. The researcher said, "Purchasing the stone on eBay was easy. The challenge was to make Rydberg polaritons that exist in an extremely narrow color range." The team is currently further refining these methods to explore the possibility of making quantum circuits, which are the next ingredient for quantum simulators.